welcome you again into the Called Out Ministry telecast. Last week, I spoke about sin, particularly the scar of sin. That sin is dangerous. Sin is never a friend, but a killer. And that sin is everywhere. Sin is so civilized, and sin is deadlier than cancer. Today, I'm bringing to you what I titled, A Life Without God. I've seen so many people in our world today living their lives the way it pleases them, as if they are the governor of their lives, and of course, they are the leader of their ideologies. They have successfully programmed God out of their lives, and that is a serious case in their lives. But you in particular that is hearing me now, the Lord wants me to sensitize you about the life you are living. This particular life you are living doesn't belong to you. It is a borrowed one. And of course, life can be invested, life can be wasted, life can be used or utilized for God, and life can as well be sold out to devil and you become satanic ambassador. A life without God is an empty life. A life without God is a dry one. A life without God is full of darkness. A life without God is filled with hypocrisy. A life without God is a satanic workshop. A life without God is a demonic residential apartment. A life without God is a place of sin, a palace of corruption, and a palace of, a palace of pollution. In Luke chapter 12 and in verse 15, Jesus Christ said unto his disciples, and as he said unto his disciples then, so also is telling you and me today in verse 15. And he said unto them, take heed. What does it mean? Be very careful. Be vigilant. Take heed because of covetousness. Take heed. Beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. You see, one of the reasons why so many people live their lives today as if God will never bring them to book is not because they've been so wicked in their attitude and dispositions for so many years and judgment seem not to come. But be reminded one more time that there is time for everything in life. Do not live your life without God. Don't live your life outside the will of God. Otherwise, you will be undoing yourself unknowingly. A life without God is a shallow life and is going to be fruitless. A life without God is full of regret, is full of sorrow and pain. A life without God is a useless one and clueless altogether. A life without God is a disorganized, disjointed life. A life without God is full of painful memories, is a black market and a back market for the devil. A life without God is the marketplace of the taskmasters. A life without God is a life without peace, is a life without direction. A life without God will lack direction for distinction. A life without God will lack what I call divine backing. Because God will leave you to it and you are going to suffer big time. Live your life for God. Let him be the leader of your life. I want to remind you again in Luke chapter 12, verse 15, Jesus said, take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. Why do you want to kill yourself? Because of the good things of life. If you are patient enough, God knows when and how to bless you. And your life will be bringing and producing glory for God. And not that you will become useless, a useless entity, so to say, because you are just living your life the way it comes to you. I want to ask you, who are you in terms of personality? And what do you have in terms of possession? Remember one more time, you will account for your life on the final day when your life in this world is over. Eternity is already knocking at your heart. Settle it now before you get there. Otherwise, you are going to lament eternally in hell. May that never be your portion. Meet me again same time next week. God bless you.